In this video, I'll cover creating a terrain setback line for a site plan. In this sample plan, I already have a terrain perimeter, and I'm going to show a 10-foot setback. Note that my save plan view here is on the plot plan view. An easy way to create a setback for your terrain perimeter is to make a copy of that terrain perimeter and concentrically resize it to the amount of your setback. To do this, I'm going to assume that my setback needs to be at 10 feet all the way around this terrain perimeter. I'm going to go into my preferences and set the concentric resize amount. Underneath my edit menu, I'm going to come down to preferences. Underneath the edit behaviors, there's an edit type section, and underneath the concentric information is a jump amount. I'm going to change this jump amount to be 10 feet. I'm going to leave the edit type still in default. I typically won't change it to be concentric because that way I can retain all the typical editing that I normally do. The jump amount is set to 10 feet. Go ahead and close this dialog. I'm going to click on the terrain perimeter. In my lower edit menu, I'm going to select the copy button, and I'm going to come over and I'm just going to hover over the corner of this diamond. You see my cursor change. At this point, I'm going to press the letter C for concentric on my keyboard. While I'm holding the letter C down, I'm going to left click and I'm going to slide my mouse up. You'll see the terrain perimeter jump. At that point, I'm going to release both, and then I'm now going to open this up and assign it to a setback and also change the line style to be dashed. I'll double click to open up the object. On the selected line, this will show you what layer this object is on. Notice that it's on the CAD default. Even though I made a copy of the terrain perimeter, program only allows you to have one terrain perimeter. So when I made a copy of it, it just became a simple CAD object. I want to change the layer so that it's on a new layer called terrain setback. So I'm going to go ahead and click the define button. And then I'm going to make a copy of the CAD default layer using the copy button. This created a new layer called CAD Default 3, and I'm just going to rename this to Terrain Setback. And then I'm going to change the line style to be a dashed line style. I like to create this new layer because I don't want this on a general CAD layer, especially for my construction drawings. Now I'm going to go ahead and close these dialogs. You can now see the dashed line for the setback using your dimension tool. I'm going to come in. I'm actually going to use the point-to-point dimension. As I drag this out, you can see that it's 10 feet on all sides. And then if you want to add a text call out, come in here, maybe text with leader line, come over. And I'm just going to call this the terrain setback. If your setback doesn't have to be symmetrical, this can easily be added as a polyline. Just simply click on it. You can resize this however you need to. That wraps up this video on the terrain setback. Please see our other terrain videos as well as our built-in help file to learn more. Thanks for watching.